Good morning. Please rise for the Star Spangled Banner on national anthem. May everybody please stand up. Please sit down. Welcome, thank you for being here. It's really a pleasure to be the principal of such a wonderful family, Latino Youth High School, and see my young adults so well, nice as you asked, ready for their graduation after such a long and challenging journey. But it's been a journey worth it. Now we're here, graduation here is finally here, right? After all the homework and the quizzes and the Mr. and the Mrs. And all these things that we go through in high school. But good thing that our community provides, not a second chance, but a better chance, and a much better chance, so that we can continue our future towards our career and college. Thank you for allowing me to be part of your family. My name is Dr. Ernest Gonzalez, and I've been the principal there starting in January, so it's been quite a wonderful experience. I'm having a good time. I love the work. I love to come to work every morning, and that's something very special to say, because right now, Saucedo and the Latino Youth High School has provided not only the opportunity for the students, but for the community. I remember when I was a young student in college, and I was studying slavery. You know, one of the biggest crimes that a slave could commit was to learn how to read and write. Because once you're educated and you learn how to read and write, you're free. At Latino Youth High School, we're providing freedom through the education we're providing. It's the biggest treasure you can ever have. This is something nobody can take away. Please give yourself a round of applause for this. Every day, and these are the heroes behind the scenes, and these are our families and our community members. Students, let's give our families and our community members a nice hand. Nice, thank you. Thank you for being here. You're the heroes. I want to thank our Chief Executive Officer, Dr. Francisco Cisneros, Compliance Officer Monica Massana, and our lawyer at our institution, Zika Cummings. I want to thank also, this could not have been done with a magnificent staff. Look how beautiful that looks. Let's give them a hand. There's a lot of people that work behind the scenes, and a lot of people from Pilsen Wellness Center are here. I want to thank them also. Without them, this could not have been done this way. So please, give them a hand. I've been working with the school, with Saucedo, Maria Saucedo Elementary School, Scholastic Center, for some time now, trying to coordinate this. The school people and the workers here have been great. I want to give a special thanks to a person that works in this school. He's right here behind us. He's the one who's doing all the sound and music. Juan. Please have yourself place in there. Okay, Juan, thank you for all that. Right? We have a person that I want to recognize who's not here. Her name is Carmen Mourinho. want to give her a special recognition. She's been with us for many years right now. She's recuperating. She's doing better. We love her so much. Carmen, wherever you are, we love you. Let's give her a hand. Also, on a sadder note, but we have to do these things. Last week, we lost a member of our school. I'm not going to go in detail. But I would like right now to hold a moment of silence in honor of our friend. You all know who I'm talking about. Thank you. Let's proceed. Ladies and gentlemen, students and staff, we have the honor, and I say the honor, I just met this man today, and he's going to be our keynote speaker. So please, let's welcome the Honorable Mark A. Sandoval, Senator of the 11th Legislative District, State of Illinois. Senator.
Felicidades por llegar a este gran momento en la vida de sus hijos. Ellos no hubieran podido llegar a este momento sin el apoyo, el cariño y el sostenimiento de ustedes, los padres de familia en casa. El reto no ha terminado, señores y señores. The journey is not over, parents. It has only begun. The world has only become more complex today. La vida es muy complicada hoy día aquí en las calles de Chicago. No porque sus hijos han graduado de la high school, ya pueden decir, ya terminé. It is not enough to say that my children graduated from high school and I am done. I am complete with my responsibilities. No, parents. This is just a start. And it is a wake-up call. It is a wake-up call to continue to invest with love and care and interest into your children. These are still children. They live under our roof. They are our responsibility. It is important for them, for you to continue to instill in them, tell me where you're going. What are your goals? What do you want to be? What do you want to do? They should have answered that question already. You should have started that discussion many years ago. And if you haven't started that discussion, start it today. It's never too late. Señores, hoy día es el empiezo de empezar a tener esa discusión con sus hijos. Si no lo han tenido, ¿a dónde vas a llegar, hijo, hija? Tienes que lograr más. Tienes que ir a la universidad. Tienes que hacer una carrera corta. Tienes que aprender un oficio. Y si no ha tenido esa discusión con sus hijos, empiézalo hoy. Hoy es el día que empieza esa discusión. Y padres y madres de familia, no han terminado. Hay que seguir invirtiendo cariño, amor, comprensión. Y no hay día, empezando hoy, que se le siga preguntando al hijo y a la hija, ¿con quién andas? ¿A qué horas vas a regresar? ¿A dónde vas? It is to the parents, you have to continue being involved in the lives of your children. You must ask them. You must know, who are you with? Who are you hanging out with? You need to know who they are. You need to know their parents. You need to know where they're going. You need to know what time they're coming home. Yes, they don't like those questions. But you must continue to challenge them. As long as they are living under your roof, as long as you're responsible, you must ask and be part of their lives. They cannot, and this is a testament, they are not, and going not to be, if you have anything to do with it, a statistic in society. I congratulate parents, los felicito a los madres y padres de familia por este gran día. Yo soy producto de la inmigración ilegal de México. I am a product of illegal immigration from Mexico. Yes, my parents crossed the river, the Michoacán and the Guanajuato, and they dedicated their lives to their children. I've had a chance of taking advantage of an education and being somebody. I have parents who are just like yours, that care, that were involved, that were engaged. I congratulate the parents. Ladies and gentlemen with grudges, I want you to stand up, turn around, stand up, turn around, give your parents a round of applause and say thank you. You may sit down, graduates. I will be brief. To the students, congratulations. This is a wonderful day of celebration. Let's see those smiles on those faces, because you know, to get to this point has been a challenge for most of you. This is not the usual route course that you took maybe 4 years ago, but this is where you ended up at. And you know what? You succeeded. Through all the challenges that life had put before you, through some of the challenges that you put before yourself, because you have no one other to blame sometimes for all the hardships that we go through in life, because it's about the decisions you made the last 4 years in your life. Some have been good decisions, some have been bad decisions. But you made it. You made it, and you graduated from high school. And that's important, and you to be celebrated and congratulated for that. But it's not over. Graduates of 2015, this is only the start. You know, I had a chance, and I want to tell you a quick story. When I see all of you sitting in those chairs, I see myself. There's no excuses for succeeding in the United States of America, in this great country. Don't buy everything, well, it's difficult, it's tough, I don't know what to do, I don't know what to do. Look, I was born in the back of the yard. It's a tough neighborhood, it's the hood, the barrio. Mexican parents who landed on Plymouth Rock, back of the yards, 44th and Hermitage, Davis Square Park. Yeah, I know what it's like. Not because I'm a state senator, I don't know what the streets are like. I know what the streets are like. I had friends like you had. I had girlfriends that you had. Those that caused me a lot of problems. Those that led me down the wrong path. Yeah, I had those too. I had those too. I was convinced as a young man that I was not going to stay in the neighborhood, that I was going to be somebody, that I was going to make, and that the sacrifice that my parents made that left Mexico, see, most of you are Mexican, some of you are African American, and I'll tell you through your story. Most of you are Mexicans, Americans, Mexicans, whose parents left Mexico, they left their country. Who leaves their country? I dare you to leave your country and go to some far off land where you don't know the language, you don't know the people, you don't have anything in your pocket. You leave your mother, your father, your daughter, your children, your grandma. You even leave the goat and the sheep and the mule. They left everything for you. And what's your response? Hanging out with the wrong people? Just going through life? Making mistake after mistake? Is that how you're going to respond to your parents? Is that what they want of you? No. They want you to own a piece of the American dream, and that is being financially, economically well off. That's important. And educated. They both go hand in hand. The amount of education usually is equivalent to how much you're going to make in life. Don't let anybody tell you otherwise. And you know what? If you want to be digging ditches for the rest of your life, go right ahead. You won't last long. I want to live long. You want to live long. The way to live long is through education. Statistically, if you go to college or university, you'll probably live longer than a guy who's digging ditches on California and 26th Street. It's a tough job. Your parents did that. Your parents worked all their lives digging ditches, working in restaurants, working in factories. They don't expect that of you. They expect greater things of you. That's not why they left Mexico. To the African Americans, what a great story. You even had it rough, rougher than the Mexicans, because your ancestors were brought over as slaves. Tough, discriminated. And look at you today. I had the privilege of living with a tall, skinny black man for 4 years, a few years ago. He's now today the most powerful man in the free world. His name is Barack Obama. Yeah, he was my roommate. He was my roommate for 4 years. I visit the White House. Yeah, I'm from back in the arts. From the hood, from the barrio. Who would ever thought that a tall, skinny black man in America would be elected president of the United States of America? Who would ever thought? The naysayers were, there's a long list of them. And they said that a young man by the name of Barack Obama could never be president of the United States. And for you, the African Americans sitting in the graduates, if Barack could do it, you can too. Yes, he can. Yes, you can do it. Si se puede. He knew also that in order to get ahead in life, you need to be educated. And boy, was he educated. University of Chicago Law, Harvard, distinguished academic career. Divorced parents, separated parents, yet he succeeded. Graduates of 2015, I commend you for getting to this point. But you now have to decide, you're now at the major crossroads in your life. Will you be satisfied with just a high school degree, high school diploma? Will you sit there and just kind of say, well, I need to take some time off. I need to think about life. Or will you decide, no, I gotta continue this. I will continue, I will either go to trade school, learn a trade, I will go learn a short administrative career at a community college, I will go to a four-year university, I will go into the service, I will do something productive in my life so that in 4 years I can live a lot better and I can, my children, someday you will get married, most of you, your children will be better off than you were because you are better off perhaps than your parents. You know, they say that statistically we will live about 80 years, graduates of 2000. 80 years, that's the average lifespan of America, 80 years. You know, if you get the first, and if you graduate, if you're focused and you graduate and go to college, you should be about 21, 22. If you do it right, if you stay focused, if you're disciplined. And you know what, if you get the first 21 years of your life right, you'll live the next 60 years better off. Because if you don't get the first 21 years of your life together, you're gonna make the next 60 years a lot tougher. You will struggle, it'll be rough. So, this is tough love, I know it's tough love, I know you don't like to hear it, this is tough love. But you know what, it's a tough world out there. And I know you can make it, I know you can do it. You just gotta want it. You just gotta want it with your whole heart and soul. Congratulations to the class of 2015 for getting to this point. And you know what? God bless you on your journey, and I wish you the best of luck to you and your families. Thank you very much.
First with wisdom. Let's proceed. May I please have Maria Vega, historian, please come up. Celine Martinez, please come up. Celine Martinez, for overall excellence in academics, Latino Youth High School. Congratulations, Celine. Thank you. For overall excellence in academics and leadership, Latino Youth High School 2015, Bernice Romano. Maria Vega, for overall excellence in character and academics, Latino Youth High School 2015, congratulations. Now we will have some words from the salutatorian and the valedictorian.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Berenice Romano, and I am honored to be valedictorian.
And hi, my name is Maria Vega, and I am honored to be the salutatorian.
We want to say first thanks to all the teachers and staff members for getting all of us this far.
Without their help and support, we wouldn't have accomplished this.
So let's give our teachers and staff members a round of applause. So as we all know, we remember our first day coming to Latino U. It doesn't matter if we came in first quarter, second quarter, or third quarter. We all had the same mutual feeling of being nervous on the first day. But thankfully, we had our teachers and staff members who pushed us far and motivated us to get this far today to walk on the stage to receive our diploma.
But this journey does not stop here. This is merely the beginning of a journey called life. We will continue to stay motivated, keep moving forward, and accept any challenges that can come on our way. There will be times where we'll shut in our face and we will want to quit, but don't quit. Know that baby steps count too and eventually add up to success. I feel that we all have learned from Latino youth is to continue working hard and always go to an extra mile even when times are rough. We won't back down. We will achieve and we will overcome any obstacle that comes our way. In Jesus' name, I pray so. Class of 15, we made it.
Those are our leaders of the future. Now we will continue myself and Dr. Francisco Cisneros and the conferral of diplomas. Okay, before that, what we're going to do is Armando Venegas, are you around? Are you the one going to be?
Venegas!
Buenos días, alumnos, padres, personal y administración. Durante los últimos tres años, los maestros de Latino Youth de CHIAX Local 4343 han recaudado fondos hacia la beca Latino Youth Manda una Estrella al Colegio. Hasta este año, los fondos totales recaudados nos han permitido otorgar un estudiante de Latino Youth High School con una beca. Sin embargo, estoy orgulloso y emocionado al decir que con nuestros esfuerzos más recientes hemos recabado suficientes fondos para financiar no una, sino dos becas que cada una cubre un semestre completo de estudios en uno de nuestros colegios comunitarios de Chicago. Vamos a dar a nuestros maestros una ronda de aplausos por sus esfuerzos. Nuestros becarios fueron seleccionados en base a sus logros académicos, perseverancia y deseo de servir y mejorar sus comunidades. Así que en nombre de los maestros de Latino Youth de Chi-X Local 4343, es mi privilegio presentar la beca Latino Youth Manda una Estrella al Colegio a Paola Tapia y Berenice Romano.
Valentina Alaniz. can get started. What's coming up next is, you know, further more education and see where that takes us.
So I say my name first, or? Okay. Hi, I'm Sheldon Diaz, and I just graduated. Feels good, you know, finally got everything done. It's hard, but I'm done. Some of the hard stuff is probably the complicated essays, the final projects I had to do. Or just killer. I'd like to thank my teachers, my parents, especially my mom who helped me out, my dad who took me to school every day, helped me get on top of things. My band manager who, you know, he's helping us get famous, getting on a official label company. Recording with my band.